हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल स्टडी व्हाट इज़ द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मेमेलियन स्पर्मेटोजोआ एंड सम इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्म्स रिलेटेड विद द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्पर्मेटोजोआ. स्पर्मेटोजोआ स्पर्म इज़ अ हाईली स्पेशलाइज्ड सेल. इट्स स्पेशलाइजेशन इज मेंट फॉर टू पर्पजेज. इट हैज़ टू रीच द एग एंड इट हैज़ टू एंटर इन टू एग ड्यूरिंग फर्टिलाइजेशन. Mammalian sperm, as we have studied earlier, is divisible into four parts: head, neck, middle piece and tail. Head comprises highly condensed nucleus and acrosome. Nucleus, which is covered by nuclear envelope, it mainly contains condensed DNA and basic proteins. Acidic proteins, RNA and nucleolus, they are absent. Nucleus is covered by means of acrosome. So acrosome lies between nuclear envelope and plasma membrane. A part of acrosome covers the anterior part of the nucleus. This part of acrosome is known as the proximal segment, and the lower part, which covers the posterior part of nucleus, is known as the equatorial segment. Basically, it is the equatorial segment by means of which sperm it comes in contact with the egg. Just behind the equatorial segment is a post-acrosomal region made up of very dense material. So acrosome is covered by means of its own sheath. Acrosome is formed from Golgi bodies, you know, and it contains hydrolytic enzymes and it helps in the penetration of sperm into egg. So this is regarding head and head part, which comprises nucleus and acrosome. Then there is a short neck. This neck has two centrioles. Proximal centriole mainly plays a role in cleavage, first cleavage of the zygote. From the distal centriole arises the axil filament. So these are two centrioles. Centrioles, they have 9+0 arrangement of microtubules that you have studied in lower classes also. So from the distal centriole arises the axil filament that extends into middle piece and the tail. In the middle piece, this axil filament is surrounded by spirally arranged mitochondria. So there is a thin layer of cytoplasm plus spirally arranged mitochondria. Mitochondria, they are the powerhouse of the sperm because they provide ATP molecules for which in turn give energy for the movement of sperm. So this is the middle piece. Tail mainly comprises axil filament covered by thin layer of cytoplasm covered externally by means of plasma membrane. So this is regarding the structure of mammalian sperm. Now we will study the structure of axil filament, detailed structure of axil filament. This axil filament has 9+2 arrangement of microtubules. You have studied it in lower classes also. There are two singlets in the center connected by double bridge and covered by central sheath. And there are 9 doublets around the central singlets. So doublet means each is having 2 subtubules. So this is the, you can say, enlarged part where you can say each doublet is made up of 2 subtubules, A subtubule and B subtubule. Here just see, A subtubule is further made up of 13 protofilaments, whereas B subtubule is incomplete. It is made up of 10 subfilaments, 10 protofilaments. So B subtubule shares 3 subtubules with the 3, you can say, protofilaments with the A subtubule. So this is A subtubule, this is B subtubule. This part has been elaborated. From the A subtubule there arises 2 arms. Then these doublets, they are interconnected by inter-doublet link. Then from the doublet arises the radial spoke, which is having spoke head near the central sheath. So whole structure resembles just like a cartwheel. The important point over here is that these subtubules, they are made up of tubulin protein. Inter-doublet link is made up of nexin protein. Whereas these arms, they are very important. These arms, they are made up of dynein protein. This dynein protein is very important because it acts as ATPase enzyme. It will help to convert ATP into ADP and only then energy will be released for the movement of sperm. So these dynein arms, they are very important. Related with these dynein arms, there is a syndrome which is known as immotile cilia syndrome. In some persons, sperms, they are normal. Externally, they appear to be normal. But person's sperm does not contain these dynan arms. So as these dynan arms they are absent, it means the person lacks ATPase enzyme, which has to convert ATP into ADP and inorganic phosphate, and which provides energy for the movement of sperm. So in such a person, that due to lack of these dynan arms, sperms they can't move, and the person is infertile. And this disorder is known as immotile cilia syndrome. This is basically caused by an autosomal recessive mutation. So this is a very important term which is related to the structure of axil filament. Then likewise, there is an important term, spermiation. You have studied how sperm mother cell undergoes mitotic division to form spermatogonia. Then it undergoes meiotic divisions to form primary and secondary spermatocytes. During these mitotic and meiotic divisions, basically cytokinesis, that is division of cytoplasm, is incomplete. It means all the daughter cells, they remain connected with one another, forming a group of cell. That group of cell is known as clone. Only in late meiotic divisions or only in late spermiogenesis, sperms, they separate from each other. They get separated from this clone of cells. The process of release of sperm from the clone of cells is known as spermiation. So these are two important terms related with the structure of sperm. Then in mammalian sperm, outside these doublets, there are present 9 outer dense fibers. What is the function of these dense fibers? These dense fibers, they simply provide additional force for the vibration of the tail, and they provide elasticity to the tail. So they are present in mammalian sperm. Now what are the functions of sperm? It activates the egg to start development. It contributes male, haploid or paternal set of chromosomes to the zygote, and it provides centriole, which is the proximal centriole, to the zygote for first cleavage. So this is all about first topic of unit 1, that is spermatogenesis. We will continue later on.